टुडे आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव टू स्टडी बाउंड्री कंडीशन दैट इज वन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक बाउंड्री कंडीशन एंड सेकेंड वाज द मैग्नेटिक बाउंड्री कंडीशन एंड नेक्स्ट मूव टू योर पॉइंटिंग थ्योरम एंड पॉइंटिंग वेक्टर फर्स्ट स्टार्ट योर बाउंड्री कंडीशन. बाउंड्री कंडीशन मीन्स इफ फील्ड एग्जिस्ट बिटवीन टू डिफरेंट मीडिया. फील्ड एग्जिस्ट बिटवीन टू डिफरेंट मीडिया यू सी हियर this one of the media and this second of the media and separated by a interface means field exists in a region consist of two different media. The condition that field must satisfy at interface separating the media is called boundary condition. The conclusion this means if field is present in a both medium you see here one of the electric field is E1 and second is the E2. This field is present in the two different media. Now to separate this different media, what condition is followed to separate this medium? That is condition is known as boundary condition. We first describe the electric boundary condition. Now this interface between medium 1 and medium 2 is the dielectric. What is means by dielectric? Dielectric means this medium, one of the dielectric and this one of the second dielectric. This is represented by the epsilon 1 and this one is represented by epsilon 2. Here you see here the electric field is E1 medium 1 and electric field E2 in second medium. Now this electric field is break in a two component. One of the tangential component you see here, this is your tangential component, this one is your normal component. Similar manner this also break E2 electric field E2T, this one E2T and this one your normal component. Now to describe this electric boundary condition we use two laws, that is one of the E dot dl line integral of electric field is equal to zero and second one is the Gauss law, that is the D dot ds surface integral of D dot ds is equal to Q enclosed. By using this relation we consider a closed path. To describe this one we applying this one relation first. Here we consider a closed path ABCDA and this one your VC is the distance del H and DC with its distance is the del W. Now applying this relation in this electric field and using your closed path you see here E1T multiplied by del W, E1T dot del W means tangential component of E1 and width of this path. You see here this one your direction similar way in this region medium 1, this one medium 2, this one medium 1. This you see here E1T is the same direction as the path A and B. Then we use E1T multiplied by del W. This one come to relation. Now next you move E1N multiplied by del S by 2 means del S is divided into two different media, means this portion is come del S by 2, next one is come to del S by 2. Total is right, come to del H. Now we see here E1N normal component E1 multiplied by del S by 2. You see here what is this one comes negative. You see here E1N means this one your direction E1N and your this distance direction is just supposed, means this direction follow this one, this follow this one, means upward direction is E1 and bottom direction is B and C. That's why negative point is indicated here and electric field component and distance multiplied. Then again similar way move to next E2T multiplied by del W. You see here E2T is the just direction and this one is the second medium and this direction is the just opposite. That's why here is negative. This one in term is calculated. Now we move to next one E2N multiplied by del S by 2. Now to see here E2N is the this direction and you see here first we observe this one and this direction is this one, means just opposite to each other. That's why here is negative. Next you move E2N, here use plus, means this value is used here, distance is used here, this direction is indicate this one, and similar same direction use this one, which both are positive, means same direction, that's why you use positive sign is here. Similar way, we multiply by E1 del S by 2, means this direction E1 and del S by 2, this distance is not, this distance is multiplied. Means overall, all the path which is indicated and break in the two portion, that is two portion which were divided, B and C and D and A, and multiply using the direction which is indicated by electric field component, and then the summation equal to value is 0, then summation value is equal to come 0. Now arrange is some are cancel out to each other, you see here this one cancel out, then against this one cancel out, this one relation is cancel out, this one is cancel out, then this come in this form and arrange is this one is come your one of the condition of electric field. This relation shows you means the tangential, this one is your tangential component of electric field E1 and tangential component E2 in second medium. This one shows tangential component of electric field the same and both sided. At boundary both sided, E1t is equal to E2t. In other words, this also you say that E t undergoes, tangential component of electric field undergoes no change in the boundary. Means in the boundary, these two component E1t and E2t not change. Now you see here by using this relation, we use the relation that is your electric flux density. This one your relation electric flux density. Now arrange this one, this form is come out. Now put this value in medium 1 and medium 2. You see here this value is different, this value is different. This indicates that tangential electric flux density undergoes change across the interface. Means in medium 1 and medium 2 changes across the boundary. You see here this one shows you equal to, this one is not equal to at the boundary. This one shows you relation. Other way you also say DT is said to be discontinuous across the boundary. Now move to next use of relation to calculate your boundary condition. You see here next use. Now applying this relation and consider this diagram to calculate your electric flux density relation condition. Okay, now we apply this one relation. You see here the electric flux density medium 1 and medium 2 is D1 and D2. Now to break in a tangential component, normal component. This one normal component, this one tangential component. We consider one of the Gaussian surface. The top and bottom area is del S and length of this Gaussian cylindrical surface is del H. Now here you see the relation. This one is the D multiplied with area and equal to total charge. This one is so your relation. We consider the del S times to 0. Now using this relation, you see here this one you come to difference between bottom and top and bottom, that we take a difference normal component of medium 1 and normal component of electric flux density medium 2 multiply by this area ds, url multiply and in the difference between this portion top and bottom and equal to charge. This one shows charge. Now arrange this one, our this value is come in this form, and this was your charge density. Charge density placed at a boundary. This suppose there is a charge present in this boundary. This one shows your relation rho s. Now arrange this value, it comes in terms of this relation. Now suppose rho s value is equal to 0 here, show you rho s value is equal to 0, then this one shows you D1N means electric flux density normal component of medium 1 and medium 2 is equal. This means implies that D is continuous across the boundary. Now using this relation, we arrange, you see here that D is equal to epsilon E. You put here D is equal to epsilon E and medium 1 and medium 2. I arrange this one, we see here this one relation. This indicates that normal component of electric field and medium second normal component discontinuous across. Means this one is the different value, this one the different value. That's why discontinuous across the boundary. If come to same value, this word is the continuous. Is similar here word also use a continuous. Means E1T is equal to E2T is the continuous at the boundary. This one also show you continuous at the boundary. And this one show discontinuous at the boundary. Next to move magnetic boundary condition. In the magnetic boundary condition, we use two relation to describe this magnetic boundary condition. Similar way you calculate the magnetic boundary condition at which you already in above pages you are calculated. By using this relation, we applying your S dot DL means Ampere circuit law in a closed path ABCDA. Here we indicate here in this portion, there is indicate there is a surface current is present in this boundary. That is dependent by the surface current divided by K. This one other notation use the K. This one shows you K is the surface current present in the boundary. Now you similar way you calculate this relation H1T and multiplied del W. You see in the above pages already. And arrange this value, you come. Also, you directly use del S tend to 0, and where is the del S, put the value is 0 and also come in this form. Other way, you cancel out to each values which is equal to, and value come in this way. Suppose K is equal to 0, surface condensate is 0, then this one come in this form. This one shows it continuous, means tangential magnetic field intensity is continuous at the boundary. This one shows you relation. This word is a tangential component. This is a tangential component is continuous at the boundary. And suppose B, we have seen the relation B is equal to mu H. Arrange this one, this come in this form. This one shows you means tangential component of B is discontinuous. So here the BT is discontinuous at the boundary. Now we apply the second relation. B dot ds is equal to 0. Now B multiplied by del S, we use this diagram to describe the next relation and use this relation and multiply the arrange this value come this in this form. This one shows you normal component of B is continuous. If arrange this in this form, this one shows you normal component magnetic flux magnetic field intensity is discontinuous at the boundary. Means this one is a continuous at the boundary, this one is discontinuous at the boundary. Now we conclude the boundary condition. You also use this explanation boundary condition. This condition is helpful. What is the purpose of this boundary condition? If one medium is available field component, then we can easily calculate the second medium. That's we use a boundary condition to calculate in a different medium electric field and magnetic field component. This one shows you. Here is summarized form. Here we consider this one your electric field. This one side your electric field. This one is side your magnetic field boundary condition. Here is summarized form. We already consider dielectric boundary condition. Also, maybe dielectric to free space or dielectric to conductor or free space to conductor. Similar way means two different media is present. Here we consider dielectric bonding condition, dielectric bonding condition. This one comes to relation continuous E1T is equal to E2. This one comes to discontinuous. If we already have this relation, then you easily calculate this one. Next to move this, we have relation rho s. If rho s is equal to 0, then come to this leg and this one shows you continuous. By this relation, we continue the discontinuous. This one shows you if we have the conductor and dielectric separation means two different media, conductor, one of the conductor and second is the dielectric. Then come tangential component equal to 0 and normal component of electric field is equal to rho s. Is the different relation, that's here is not show you. You just use dielectric boundary condition to describe this relation. And next one is the similar way, magnetic field. This one indicate mu 1 and mu 2, the medium one is the mu 1 and second is the mu 2. And continuous at your normal component and discontinuous of this relation. And if surface charge present, this is the